Deacon Def Jam and Reverend Adnoy.
Yes, yes. Welcome to the JPJJ. Ooh. That is the jackpot joined with Jerusalem.
Yes,
ching ching.
Hallelujah.
Yes, hallelujah. Alright, alright. As you know, I am Deacon Def Jam, and joining me, of course, is the wonderful Reverend Adnoy.
So I've never been this stopped up this way I am now. This is unbelievable.
Did you get your vaccine?
There's so much in there that I just couldn't get. I don't know how I'm going to get this out, but I'll try to make it.
Why do you not blow your nose?
I'm trying that. It's just, it's full. I'm just saying they're full. Go right ahead.
TMI. Right.
All right. Well, let me put this out there. I'm going to be giving you the church complaints. And if he can get it out of his nose, he's going to be giving you the church announcements.
Yes. Go right ahead.
Lord have mercy. All right. Cornbread Willie is asking for the COVID medicine. He would like us to put the medicine in his cornbread. As you know, he eats cornbread for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Do you think we can get that approved to put it in his cornbread?
That is a great idea. He eats cornbread all the time. And if you put it in there, he'll never know. That way he'll be vaccinated, and that would be great for everybody to get him vaccinated. That is perfect. I like that idea.
What?
He gets vaccinated.
Through the cornbread.
Vaccinated. He needs to be vaccinated. Anyway, we have a lost and found report from the janitor. Over the weekend, he found one black see-through waist slip, a half a can of Coke, an empty purple bottle, and a glass eye. The eye was in the bag. So if these are your items, we need you to go.
Wait. What are we missing?
It was a black see-through waist slip, a half a can of Coke, in an empty purple bag, and a glass eye. The eye was in the bag. It was turned inside out, so I don't know if it was Crown Royal or not, but there was an eye in the bag. And if these are your items, please report to Lost and Found to retrieve them. I'm sure you need these items. Go right ahead.
Missing an eye. They must have dropped the crown and took
In other
eye.
Words, come on down and get it. We'll keep an eye out for you.
Why can't they just pour the eye out?
Come on down and get it. We'll keep an eye out for you. Go right ahead. I'm sorry.
All right. Here's the situation. Bo Willie has just found out that Bo Willie Jr. and Flo Willie are not his set of twins. As you know, they are 35 years old now. They have found out that their father is Joe Willie, which is Bo's younger brother.
Yes.
Therefore, Joe's funeral is this coming Thursday. The family is not paying for the funeral. We need to decide if we're going to pay for the funeral. As you know, they are members of the JPJJ.
I understand it. In other words, she had sex with the other Willie. See what I did there?
Yeah.
See what I did there? I'm cracking me up. Okay. A $5 bet.
Are you all right?
I'm feeling good. Was the reasons the paramedics had to be called to Wilhelmina Jeffcoat's house over the weekend. They had to use the jaws of life to get her out of a hula hoop. Now, here's the thing.
What happened? The jaws?
The jaws
of life. I missed it.
The bet wasn't that she could hula hoop. The bet was, could she get in it? She did, and she won. So that.
And they cut her out of that.
They cut her out of it, so they had to call the paramedics. Go right ahead.
The wheelchair track team ministry wants to challenge the Jamaican girls track team in the 4x100 relay. They want to challenge them for their gold medal. Now, as you know, the wheelchair track team consists of Rosie, Dolores, Celestine, and Francis. And they want to challenge the Jamaicans in a 4x100 800 relay. So it's all about us if we gonna support them getting this done at night.
That's celestial stuff, though.
Not I, I would never.
They gonna lose.
They gonna lose to Jamaica.
I put my money on the wheelchair. Here we go.
Okay.
I know they gonna be. They gonna be rolling. We know
they
gonna
be rolling. I like that.
They gonna be rolling for sure.
Congratulations go out to Miss Laquifa Jenkins. She is the winner of the small chow. That sounds like the devil. I had an opportunity to interview this little girl. The small child that sounds like the devil when she talks. I was up there and I interviewed her. I said, how old are you? I'm 7. And it was the most scary thing I ever seen in my life. How old are you, little girl? I'm 7. Okay. It was scary. I mean, I was a little tiny girl. I walked up to her and said, and how old are you, little girl? I'm 7. 7 years old. You heard what I said. Okay. All right.
Let's see here. Sister Gretchen Latimo, who shouts every Sunday with a triple hallelujah flip and a praise the Lord dismount, says, tell Simone Biles that she is the real goat at the end of the day, and she wants her respect. I'm just saying, Sister Gretchen say put some respect on her name. That's all she wants.
Put some respect on her name. All right. Over the weekend, the Henpeck men's meeting had to be canceled. The Henpeck men's meeting had to be canceled. When the president's wife called him up and said, I need you to bring your ass home now, right now. He adjourned the meeting and nobody got to say anything. So that happened over the weekend. Go right ahead.
All right, we got a problem. The unvaccinated members would like to challenge the vaccinated members in a game of touch football. I don't think this is going to work out that well. I really don't. But
somebody's going to get it.
They want to play them in touch football. I don't like that. I really don't like that.
Okay.
All right. On that note, thank you, Reverend Adnoy and Digging Def Jam.